election, we kick on Luke Skywalker this time, and by God, has he got yellow hair. There was some controversy way back in the 70s and 80s when this figure came out time and time again about a kind of this colour, which I had as a kid, which is there's the original, and the more brown version that came out. So there's been several versions of this figure over time. So what we've got here to compare is, there we go, there's a modern version of them, which is a loose one out of this packet here. I bought several versions of this, as I've mentioned in previous releases here, just to be sure I got this, and Hasbro kindly sent one as well. So we managed to really get a chance to look at these, but God, they cost a lot of money. If you don't have a Target, as you guys in the US do, it became very expensive for a lot of people around the world to try and pick these up, and a real hit and miss chance. Zing in Australia, where else did they appear? Target in the US, Robot Kingdom for Asia, and we don't really know where else they appeared. Not a lot of people have mentioned. Anyway, Luke Skywalker on the card. Beautiful looking artwork on that card. Of course, I have removed the gigantic retro sticker. A lot of people have said a hairdryer works. A lot of people have said different things work. Nah, it didn't really work for me. My wife is a hairdresser, and she had several hairdryers and didn't work for me. So it took a slow picking away, and it kind of left a lot of residue on the card there. So as you can see, I just can't get it off. But hopefully Hasbro improve the sticker going forward, because again, the card is completely and wildly different from the original release, and says the Retro Collection on the card back and everywhere else, so as well as Disney, which wasn't around in the 70s. So nobody should be getting confused about this, and nobody should get confused about buying these on the second-hand market, because I'll point that out to you in just a minute. But beautiful card, very nice indeed, and just looking very cool indeed. Now, the original I have here, let me move this out the way just so the camera focuses. The original I have here is still actually looking pretty damn good. Paint has obviously changed over time, and the neck and everything has weathered there. There's the saber. Now, I think this might have been a replacement at one point, minus the tip. Now, you can see here on the newer version, just incredibly bright white. It is an obvious and dead giveaway for a start. Paint has actually been sloppily applied in the newer version than the older version, as you can see there. What is supposed to be his kind of, I don't know, thing on his belt has been kind of sloppily applied in black on this newer version, but was really tight and accurate on the older one. So there's a fail for the modern version. But other than that, it's pretty minimal in terms of paint. The pants look pretty much the same, and the figure is overall the same. You can see some wear and tear as times went on the feet there. And this figure of mine certainly always had 1 foot a little shorter. You can kind of just see there, it doesn't stand very well, and it was all a bit lumpy bumpy. This one stands well and does the job. On the back of the figure, again, you can clearly see old is at the bottom, remember. Camera should focus in just a second. So one says Hong Kong and the older one, the modern one says China, and the modern one has a stamp on there. So again, you can't really get that confused. Now, where you possibly could get confused is on this lightsaber unit here. And I'm not going to take this out. There may be a small stamp on it or something, but no one's paying an absolute fortune, I would imagine, for a pull-out lightsaber. If you are, then, well, what are you doing? You can see even from this version here, it's quite different plastic. Well, you can maybe see in the camera or not, but it's very clearly differently coloured there. And there's multitudes of these replacement lightsabers out there. So really, it would be hit and miss anyway to know whether it was genuine or not. But the figures, again, wildly different. Even the yellow paint is a completely different colour. It might not show on camera, but I can tell you face to face it is. This is a more green yellow. This is a more brown yellow. Skin tones look pretty good and solid and not too dissimilar from the original, but even the shininess on the original versus the matte on that one there. So they're quite different, but same, same. There you go. Standard articulation. I don't bother talking about articulation because it's 5 points. Head rotates, arms rotate, legs rotate. That's it. Let us know what you think about this retro collection. Had luck getting it. What do you think of Luke? What one's your favourite? Leave a note. Let us know in the comments. We will see you for the next figure in this wave coming right up. By the way, if you want to buy these, link in the description below. See ya.